still. Oklahoma. Instead of going to Kentucky, we're dropping it at the terminal in Oklahoma. My older one's watching this. You remember that place?
Clocking us to be there like no later than 8:30. Now we won't be there until fucking 9:30. So we just lost like an hour since I went to sleep. And it is a straightaway with little bitty hills all the way through New Mexico and Texas. So how the hell did we lose an hour and a half? Every time a student exits to make sure they don't do anything stupid. But yeah, I like to know why every time that I go see that happens. So
I don't know what the hell his problem is, but he's still having a hard fucking time backing up. Kind of sucks when you do a straight back and it takes you longer to do a straight back than it should. another thing of candy, but there was a guy outside the truck stop with a sign just asking for a little bit of help. So I gave him a bag of chips and some candy. Fucked up thing is, I didn't give him any dang soda or anything to drink. But I gave him a bag of chips and the candy bar. But yeah, I can't remember if I told you or not, but we are going to, let me see if I can go down. We're dropping this in Oklahoma City, Oklahoma at the terminal, like I said earlier. But, oops. Pick up at Tyson. Yep. I'm not even gonna fuck that name up. So as you can see where it picks up from. Date time. Basically, make sure your reefer's cleaned out. And that's where it's going. That's when it delivers. That's how many loaded miles, empty miles of game paid. But those aren't all the miles. Those are only zip code to zip code miles. So yeah. And I just got a message earlier telling me that the receiver is not going to be open on the weekend. When am I going to be there? So it picks up on Saturday. It's only over 1,000 miles, so I'll be there Sunday morning. So we'll see if they're gonna T-call it or whatnot, and then see if they got a load coming back, or not coming back, but going to Cali. That way I can drop him off. Yeah. I should go in there and get some candy or something. But I could do that later. I stopped in New Mexico, Gallup, New Mexico, and I got fuel. I topped off on fuel. As you can see. And he drove over 300 miles. Well, before I topped off on fuel, that's when they decided to T-call my load. Oklahoma. Not a big deal. But I was able to take that other freaking, I call it gooseneck, out of my tank. The aluminum freaking uh, Yeah, the aluminum gooseneck that sits in your tank. So when you put your the pump inside your tank, it usually just it has that net in it. I guess it helps catch whatever, make sure none goes in your fuel tank. Well, I was able to actually take that out on my driver's side because it's been sitting in my tank. So I rigged shit up to actually grab it and pull it out. And I did it on the other side. I'm not sure if I posted on the other videos that I took it out, took pictures. But I was able to take it out on the left side. So hopefully now when I get lower on fuel, my gauge doesn't, like every time I hit a half a tank, my gauge will just flop down right before empty. It'll be like right there, and then it'll shoot back up to where how much fuel, and then it'll float and it'll stay around this area. So hopefully it reads accurately now. I always read accurately, but it floated a lot. So hopefully we got that taken care of. But I'm gonna go ahead and go.
Quick to go jump in the shower.
want to do, I'm gonna go look for a trailer. I'm gonna hook up to a trailer. I'm gonna get dispatched to the trailer. Released a trailer brake, the red one. Tractor brake is still set. Now you go back around. Check all the lights. Listen for any air leaks, if there's any. Level it out real quick. we send that. Go to hours of service. Approve logs. Approve logs. Cancel. What am I status on? Alright, super burst off. Good. Approve all. Now, you can send this. Could I get trailer such and such?
That gives us 3 hours to drive 100 miles.